Most people think time is like a river that flows swift and sure in one direction. But I have seen the face of time, and I can tell you, they are wrong. Time is an ocean in a storm. You may wonder who I am and why I say this. Sit down, and I will tell you a tale like none that you have ever heard. Know first, I am the son of Shahram, a mighty king of Persia. On our way to Azad with a small company of men, we passed through India, where the promise of honor and glory tempted my father into a grievous error.
Help, my son! Maharaja's treasure vaults lie within. Ha!
See how he fights. Like a warrior, son.
Do you think I felt regret as I gazed upon the destruction we had wrought? Or at least humility at the speed with which a world can be transformed from a good world into a hell? If you think so, you are mistaken. For in that moment I thought of one thing only. The honor and glory I would bring my father by fighting like a warrior in my first battle. Many men that day sought to win honor and glory on the battlefield, that their king might say to them, as Khosrow said to Rustam, "You are the noblest of my warriors." From the moment my sword tasted blood, I knew this would not be my way. I would win my father's praise not by killing, but by being the first to find the Maharaja's treasure vault and the wonders within.
Shall I continue my story from here the next time we're interrupted?
As you wish.
And there it lay, just out of reach. The Dagger of Time. There was a treasure I could carry with pride as a trophy of our victory. If I could only get there. What I came for. It was time to get out. Now.
Honor and glory.
Your Majesty, you promised me my choice of the Maharaja's treasure.
Surely you won't deny the lad a souvenir of his first battle. You may have your choice of all the Maharaja's other treasures. Except that hourglass. That will make a fine gift for the Sultan of Azad when we pass through his city. And some exotic animals for his menagerie. And a few dozen slave girls. Yes, that should be enough.
I want no animals or maidens harmed until I have chosen. Let it be known, King Saruman is merciful in victory.
Trust not a man who has betrayed his master, nor take him into your own service, lest he betray you too. I learned the truth of this, to my sorrow, the day that we arrived in Azad as the Sultan's honored guests.
My friend,
your visit brings joy and honor to my poor and humble dwelling. If only you'd given me time to prepare a proper welcome.
The glories of Azad are famed throughout the world. And yet, the best is yet to come. I give you the Sands of Time. May the friendship between our kingdoms endure as long as time itself.
The sand, why does it glow? I can tell you. Inside the hourglass is a marvel that no living man has seen.
Alas, only the dagger can unlock the Sands of Time, and it belongs to a greater one than I. A young prince, dearer to his father than all the wealth of India. Perhaps he will oblige.
No!
Time I struck them down, they rose to fight again. I soon realized that only by taking into my own dagger the sands that possess them, could I liberate them from their monstrous living death.
Now, finish him!
Thank you. done. I'll start the story from here next time. You think me mad. I can see it by the look in your eyes. You think my story is impossible. Perhaps I am mad. Who would not be driven mad by horrors such as I have lived? But I assure you, every word is true. The guest rooms, where my father, all our entourage, and I should have passed the night, lay cold and silent. The sands of time had swept through, stealing life and warmth from everything they touched. And I, who unleashed the cataclysm, had been spared. Were there others like me, who yet clung to life, hiding in fear among the ruins? It did not seem so. Had I really seen her? Or had my senses given way under the burden of horrors too great to bear and conjured up a phantom? Either way, I could not rest until I had found her again. I soon discovered that when I had collected enough sand, the dagger gained the power to stop time. Not for me, but for the enemy I struck. Whence came these visions that assaulted me thus like fever dreams? Each time I awoke feeling drained and beaten, and each time what I had seen came to pass, as if the sands of time were giving me a glimpse into my own future.
the... Hello? Is anyone there? I have a feeling I'm not in Azad anymore. Water.
Who are you?
I am Farah, the daughter of the Maharaja from whom you stole it. This is your doing.
I saw my father turn to sand.
And we will share his fate if you do not give me the dagger to undo what you have done.
Your traitorous vizier used the same words. From now on, I trust no one but myself. Run! Go back to the reception hall. Wait for me there. Go!
Oh, thank God! I was afraid you were one of them! Can you help me activate the Azad defense system? It'll take both of us to do it! I'll reset the axles for you! The man who's normally in charge of this got... Never mind! Ride the platform down to the bottom, then use those two cranks to bring it back up! You see those four axles? You'll need to pick them up one by one until you've got all four. Then, bring them up to the top together. Make sure you pick them up in the right order. That's it! You've got the first axle! Now, pick up the other three! Remember, pay attention to the grooves! That's it! One crank turns the platform! The other one raises and lowers it! Think ahead! Not yet! You need to pick up all four axles, then bring them up to the top! That's two! Just one more! That's four! Now them up to the top and line them up with their gears! There's one last step. Do you see that platform? Throw your lever, and I'll throw mine.
What manner of machine is this?
I told you, it's the palace's defense system. We did it! Serve those accursed demons right. Oh, by God, they'll rue the day they ever dared attack the palace of Azad!
I'll start the story from here next time.
What have I done?
The palace's defenses had a twisted logic of their own. They could be circumvented by using the strategically placed switches which I soon learned to recognize. Yet it was hard to escape the feeling that I had made a terrible mistake by setting in motion such a deadly system of traps, which seemed in truth more likely to claim my life than that of an invader that was not flesh and blood.
flesh. I feel as if I've been here before. I have been here before.
Feel stronger than ever.
Can you hear me?
Help me!
No, that didn't happen either.
Help me!
that's not how it happened.
I'm sorry.
Why?
I know what it is to lose a father.
That was not my father.
What are you doing?
I'll start the story from here next time.
So, this is the thanks I get for saving your life.
You don't understand. I need that dagger to undo.
To undo what I have done. Truly, you must think I'm a fool.
You are right to be cautious. But fight as bravely as you may, you cannot defeat this enemy. The sands will spread. They will consume everything. I have heard it said that you are kind as well as brave. Please believe me. Help me find the hourglass.
It is in the Sultan's treasure vault, atop the Tower of Dawn.
How do you know that?
I just know. Come with me then, if you insist. But I warn you, I move pretty fast. You better keep up.